Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to review this printer, Prestige A3+R. We have a repair shop in North Carolina, and also we go to different industrial shows about the printers' inks, so we can understand the current latest best printers. All my review here is based on one printer that's sent in by the customer, and I have no idea if something's wrong is by the customer modification or by the original brand. So the following is just my one person opinion about one printer that I saw in my shop, okay? Don't get excited. I like flat tops, so I think it's on it. However, for this printer, you have to lift the cover, put your hands in, and reset the ink level. The flat top is to defeat its purpose. Remove the cover, we can see a custom build page feeder. I like people build their own page feeder. And this one is okay-ish, and I'm decided I like the curved ones, but the straight ones is simple. If you have your customized page feeder, you don't really need those wheels. So I suggest just take this off so you don't hinder the feed. This is the manpower. I turned on the manpower supply, but it doesn't turn the printer on. I intentionally did not change the background noise level because I'm going to compare to another machine. And in here, you can see there's a really slow turning blade, and that the speed is especially slow. Actually, I talked to my friend Chris, and he thinks they wired it wrong. They wired the mixer with the pump. I don't think so, because they are turning at the same time. Another thing is that it looks like a metal blade. And not plastics. I really hate metals, like this kind of metal. The metal will rust, and there's the moisture, and I don't think a metal blade is suitable for DTF printing. I say because I've seen rusted. Yeah, the stainless steel can rust too. Because they didn't have a security tank on their white dampers, so they have to keep this peristaltic pump all the time running. There's a limit on the lifetime of peristaltic pump, and this is one thing that really is kind of weird out. As for the rusting, it could be the blades, could be the screw, or could be the solder used to weld that blade on. I've seen rusted ones. Again, here you should mount a secondary tank, so you don't have to pump the ink in all the time. Let me use another machine, show you if I did it correctly, what it looks like. Again, I did not change the noise level. And here you can see, you only need a really short and strong thorough mixing. You only run one component at a time, so you don't kill your power supply. And that's it. And all the ink get refreshed in the secondary tank, the gray square there. Not only it make a pump last longer, and also it make it more pleasant for people to keep this printer on, so the white ink can be maintained. And they did a couple of 3D printing here. That's the first I've seen for any brands. That's cool. Attached the pump is really hot. You know how this works, right? It's a contact pump, so the rubber always gets rubbed by a plastic. You guys get the idea how loud this machine is? If so, I'll turn off the volume. Okay, I'm not sure if this is from the original printer, but look, the FFC cable. Interesting. Anyway, I got to contact customers that you need a new cable. He said it's brand new. What do you mean? And I said, you need a new mainboard. He said, what do you mean? It's a brand new mainboard. Okay, I don't know where this mainboard come from. Has an Era Smart the sticker. Obviously, the F1 fuse has been replaced. The second hint, this is a used mainboard, is on the power bridge. Let's see the power bridge. If you look the back, see they are cut it at a different length. And these two longer ones replaced transistors. The reason you want to cut it short is because if those touch the metal frame underneath, you're going to get a fire. So it seems that this membrane had a power-up problem before. And another hint is, you can see here, it looks a little messy. You also can see those pins are uneven. And the reason of this problem may be Prestige did not use Epson's OEM power supply. Instead, they get a generic power supply, and then they mounted a regulator board on it. And you can see the component burn out and caught fire. Oh, by the way, if you need the wiring diagram of Prestige A3+R, go to bchtechnology.com and just search for Prestige. And here's a diagram show you where wires goes. Oh, did I mention the machine is really loud? Here's the main control board. Basically, it rewires lots of signals. For example, the page feed. When the printer wants to eject a paper, so it stops the printer from ejecting because you get a raw film on it. You don't want the film get ejected. You can think of it as a bridle of DTF1. Signal get rewired as the APG sensor. APG controls the level of your printhead carriage up and down. So if you have thicker paper, the printhead can raise up a little bit. Although this function is not used in the DTF printing, it creates lots of problems. For example, you get a 52H error. You might have air from the motor. You might have air from the sensor. There should be a motor here. And more interestingly, you can see those gears are destroyed. It gets bent sideways, and there's no way it can turn. And somebody put a red marker on it. Don't worry, this is intentional. What they did is they're going to start the machine with a regular APG. When the APG is at the optimal functional stage, they're going to kill the APG, remove the motor, and jam the gear. Whenever the printer asks, oh, where's my APG set at, they just reply with this recorded message. And your problem may be in the future, for example, your platen, there's something wrong with alignment and with everything, you cannot fix it. If you fix it, you have to somehow reinstall a healthy APG and record a position and then shut it down. Well, don't worry, just bring the printer to me. There's nothing money cannot solve. They did not do this in the previous version. Obviously, right now, they think killing the APG is a pretty good idea. As a repair person, I love it. I think it is a great idea. And this printer uses 1390, so you have a cartridge reset button here. What's interesting is to access this, you have to lift up the cover and press the button. And here it rewired the control panel on the top. The control panel should have four buttons, so they get rid of one button. What is it? Yeah, it's the page button. The page button is useful when the printer thing is auto page, and you can press that one to make the printer reload. Especially when you do the printing and you cut it off, and then when you restart the printer thing, there's a paper jam in it. So you press the button, printer will start again. I haven't got this printer running yet, so I cannot experience if you get rid of that button, if it's helpful or not. On the bottom, there's a page feed, and forward, and the reverse button. So for this printer, I'm going to rewire it. I want the power goes to a printer coming from a real Epson OEM power supply. And I'm going to 3D print three columns and put this power supply on top of the third-party power supply. There may be a long road ahead of me to get this printer fully functional, but after I'm done, I'm going to shoot another video to review the usage of this printer. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!